How to catch offenders of the law with a drone? Why did two illegal migrants try to cross the Ukrainian border instead of traveling to Paris? What treasures were hidden under the floor of a forester's hut? Watch in today's episode. This aircraft is capable of much more than its small size might suggest. It can fly up to 500 meters and observe everything that's going on below. It sends the feed to the operator, who in turn sends the information to their central information hub. Ukrainian border guards received 18 new drones as part of the international Poland-Belarus-Ukraine program. They were purchased at the expense of the European Union. Our goal is to have at least one or two, or even three such drones per unit, if our financing allows it. Such drones are extremely necessary in the line of work of the Green Berets. They facilitate surveillance of hard-to-reach areas of the border. Instead of searching for trespassers and food, it can be done remotely and without any extraneous physical expenses. Border guards learned to use the new hardware at the all-Ukrainian border guard exercises that took place in Volyn. The maximum altitude of the drone is 500 meters. It can operate at temperatures from 20 to 40 degrees Celsius and has two cameras under its propellers, an ordinary one and a thermal imaging one during night flights. It is also equipped with a GPS tracker to accurately determine coordinates of a person or a vehicle. We can put a SIM card of any operator into this GPS tracker, and then we will receive text with coordinates of the location of our drone. It is fairly difficult to hide from the all-seeing eye of the drone. The camera has 30x zoom, so number of plates are clearly visible even from a 15-meter height. I can identify the offender from a distance of 100 meters and determine if that's a person or a vehicle. Then I transmit certain information to my command. We can cover a 5-kilometer area in literally half an hour. Found the trespasser. I'm sending the coordinates to my commanding officer. I see him from an altitude of 80 meters, and he's a kilometer away from me. The practicing offender was found fairly quickly. Now a border unit is going to take over. A German shepherd named Boss knows his job really well. A swift dash, and the trespasser is being handcuffed. Fortunately, it's just a training scenario, because no one would want to be in the place of a real violator in a similar situation. Visiting border guards instead of going to Paris. Two migrants who ended up in Ukraine by accident were detained in Transcarpathia. You want to ask how? Don't ask. This story is weird and at the same time precautionary. Everyone knows that foreigners who want to make their way to EU countries are usually caught on the western border. These brave people climb over fences, hide in thickets, and risk their lives in the dense Carpathian Mountains. But sometimes it's the other way around. These two Bangladesh citizens were found on the border with Romania, and they got here from Serbia. A foreign vehicle driven by a citizen of Serbia arrived at the Djakovec checkpoint. During the inspection of this truck, border guards found two Asian-looking men who identified themselves as citizens of Bangladesh. Excuse me, are we in Paris yet? No? Oh dear! Where are we then? You can almost read this silent question in the eyes of the travelers. The foreigners themselves were quite surprised, seeing as Ukraine was not their final destination. They were trying to get to France, but most likely got in the wrong vehicle and ended up in Ukraine. The unfortunate tourists were charged with illegal border crossing. On the same day, following the readmission procedure, they were handed over to our Romanian colleagues. Apparently, they are not going to see Paris anytime soon. What conclusions can we draw from this? Watch carefully what trucks you are climbing into. Just kidding. You'd be much better off traveling legally. Watch next. Sim Sim for Smugglers. What treasures were hidden in a forester's hut? Searching for the owner. Law enforcers are figuring out who left a truck full of contraband in a parking lot. Victims of soul catchers. How to avoid ending up in a Greek prison. Smuggling is not just a criminal business, but also a well-thought-out logistics system. After all, in addition to having ways of transportation goods, its organizers also need places for secret storage. The main conditions are inconspicuousness, proximity to the border, and of course, conspiracy. A forester's hut is a great solution. This abandoned house near the Ukrainian-Romanian border meets every requirement. At first glance, it is a usual worker's hut, a place to store equipment and make some tea. However, it was not tea that smugglers were hiding under the floor. When border guards, together with their colleagues from the Mukachevo unit and representatives of the fiscal service, took a peek inside, they realized there was going to be work. One by one, they pulled out crates with cigarettes. They pulled out 36,000 packs, which local smugglers were going to ship to the EU shortly. They lost hundreds of thousands of hryvnias in revenue because the tobacco treasure is not going anywhere anymore. And this is Odessa. The local smugglers also have their secrets. The picturesque Nyorbayskaya village stretches along the Hadjibey Liman. In addition to being the largest one in Ukraine, it is also a well-known tourist center. The famous Odessa catacombs are located under it. The labyrinths that stretch across many kilometers came to be due to limestone mining and served as a base for the partisan underground during World War II. You will find out about that during a tour to the underground museum. However, today we're going to talk about this inconspicuous parking lot on the outskirts of Nyorbayskaya. Tourists don't need it, but smugglers found a use for it. It was here that border guards, together with the police and representatives of the fiscal office, found a big batch of cigarettes. 590,000 packs fit just right in the trailer of this truck. The most popular tobacco brands with smugglers turned out to be a Swiss brand without excise stamps. Who brought them to the village of partisan fame and from where is currently under investigation. And the seized goods together with the truck were estimated at 23 million hryvnias. The main task of criminal recruiters is to find those willing to participate in criminal activities and transfer them across the border. In the south of Ukraine, a criminal group was engaged in that. The group was recently uncovered by border guards and their colleagues from the police. The soul catchers were looking for unemployed Ukrainian sailors to work abroad. Their objective would be to transport illegal migrants from Southeast Asia to Italy and Greece. However, the candidates were prudently not told that it is a felony in most countries. A yacht cruise crash course in Turkey, and you are already sailing a boat with illegal migrants. But the EU law enforcement officers are also on the lookout. In the end, most of the recruits have already been arrested in Italy and Greece. They were sentenced to 30 to 50 years in jail. In total, about 250 Ukrainians who have fallen victim to criminal schemes are serving their time in Western Europe. So far, law enforcers managed to arrest the organizer and the accomplices of the criminal group. They're facing up to 12 years in prison, and they should be thankful that they're not going to serve their terms abroad.